So, just going over a little period of time, which is usually described as colonialism or removal of ancient tribes, supposedly shifted over the planet. And as there's so much based on that, and because of it, the effects on our lives, I just thought that I would bring something to notice. I'm sure a lot of people, some people know about this. I know that some of the our people who have been researching know about this since a long time, but it's not popular. It's not popular information. But there was a man called Kurlander, and he wrote several novels, one of them called Being the African. He wrote that in 1967, and the novel was about slaves being captured in Africa. His experience on a slave ship and his struggle to retain his native culture in a hostile new world, being America or a Mexican. Well, this a lot of this apparently a lot of Alex Haley's book Roots, which became the basis for a lot of our knowledge about that experience, about they would call it slave experience. I would say it's a prisoner of war experience. These are prisoners of war, they're not slaves. Slaves are something else. You have to look into the etymology of that word. But apparently, there was a trial held, a file suit against Alex Haley. Apparently, he had taken 81 passages from the novel. Kurlander's pre-trial memorandum in the copyright infringement lawsuit claimed Defendant Haley had access to and substantially copied from The African. Without The African, Roots would have been a very different and less successful novel. And indeed, it is doubtful that Mr. Haley could have written Roots without The African. Mr. Haley copied language, thoughts, attitudes, incidents, situations, plot and character. That doesn't leave a lot. The lawsuit did not allege that the African plot was copied in its entirety, as the two novels differ in many plot points. Kurlander's novel depicts a successful revolt on the slave ship, which I'm sure that if they were. There would have been many of those, but the problem is with when you look into their museums, you have to ask yourself, where are the slave ships, if there were such things? If you do not have proof of slave ships, then that also brings into question the whole idea which has been fed. There's also a fugitive life as an escape slave. That means that he actually escapes and has a life outside of that slave condition. Being recaptured by French troops and then transported to New Orleans in 1802 or whatever, 1802. So Kurlander's version is quite different in certain ways, but the main bulk of it, by the sounds of it, is very similar. So, the question is if Alex Haley has taken this whole story or a large chunk of it, how much truth is there in what he was saying? It brings into question the whole slave prisoner of war concept. In his expert witness report submitted to federal court, Professor of English Michael Woods of Columbia University stated, "The evidence of copying from The African is both the novel and the television dramatization of Roots. In both the novel and the television dramatization of Roots is clear and irrefutable." That means you cannot deny it. "The copying is significant and extensive. Roots plainly uses the African as a model." So Roots is based on the idea of someone who created his own story about Africa. But we were told that Roots was Alex Haley's history, his own family history. Do you see, that's what reinforced the story, the fact that he claimed that his family tree came from this same person, which is actually taken from a book by a European, a hybrid European. So, Roots takes from the African phrases, situations, ideas, aspects of style, and plot. Roots finds the African essential elements for its depiction of such things as a slave's thoughts of escape, the psychology of an old slave, the habits of mind of the hero, and the whole sense of life on an infamous slave ship. So that means that even the personality, the character of the person, has been dug out from somebody else's fiction, and we have taken that as true life, or some of us have. Such things are the life of a novel, and when they appear in Roots, they are the life of someone else's novel. So that's pretty much end that. When you're watching Roots, you're not watching African life, you're not watching Moorish life, you're not watching Jamaican life or Eskimaican life or anything else, Brazilian life. You're looking at a novel created with no real concrete data to prove any of this thing, because this man who wrote the story was not African. His job could have been just to create a story so that people would believe that history, because that's what Europeans often do. They often write books that are fictional. And that's putting it lightly, because fiction's a pretty good thing. But when they are untruths, they can disturb a whole load of people. And I think that's what the Roots did. I think that's what this whole Alex Haley scheme, that's what it did. So during this court during this trial. During this, the U.S. District Court Judge Robert J. Ward stated, "Copying there is, period." That means it was for sure copied. Passages from the African was found stapled to the manuscript page from Roots. You hear that? Passages from the African were found stapled to a manuscript page from the Roots. It's evidence. However, Alex Haley maintained throughout the trial that he had not even heard of the African until the year after the Roots was published, and speculated that someone else had given him the photocopied passages. I mean, can you believe that? Bizarreness. So, somebody's given him these details. So why is it presented to us as if it's his family? It's bizarre. After the trial, Joseph Bruchak, an instructor in Black and African history at Skidmore College, stated that he had recommended Kurlander's novel to Haley when he visited Skidmore in 1970. Bruchak remembered driving home 3 miles to fetch his own copy of The African and to give it to Haley, who promised to read it on the plane. I mean, this is just crazy. These guys are crazy. They say they don't know it, and then you find out somebody else gave it to them. It's like, and then we've really got it, because it's a history that's not even what we thought it was. Kurlander and Haley settled the case out of court for $650,000. That's a hell of a lot of money at that period of time. That's a hell of a lot of money. $650,000. And a statement that Alex Haley acknowledges and regrets that various material from The African by Harold Kurlander found their way into his book, Roots. That means that he admitted that the work of somebody else was in his book. And when you look at the character and what is written around that character, you could say basically that this is Harold Kurlander's version of prisoners of war from wherever, if it was ever that way. Because as far as I'm concerned, that whole basis of historians writing about other cultures, in most cases you can't believe it. You better double check, triple check on anything. Nobody speaks about Moorish history. Nobody speaks about Maroons in Jamaica, Escamaica, whatever you want to call it. Nobody speaks about them. Nobody tells you where these people all come from. They're not interested to tell you about them. They're always trying to direct you to this black and white thing, which they use. And we now find out from BLM that black and white means, you know, build your life around a mountain of houses, because they were all invested in houses. That's all they were doing. They all have properties worth millions, and the community never saw any of that money. It's ridiculous. I mean, there's a point where people have to ask themselves, is this real or is this Memorex? I mean, this is ridiculous. So now we're going to find out through the financial situation what's real and what's not, because people have they followed and followed until we've reached the edge of the cliff. So the financial situation is going to show people who's real and who's not, who really cares about you and who really doesn't, who really thinks and who really does, and who doesn't think. But this story with Alex Haley, I mean, I've known about this since years. It's just, I think that really shows a lot about what has been going on in so-called black community, Moorish community, whatever you want to call, Rastafarian. It's all misguided and deceit, and not just by Europeans, by your own people. You know, by your own people. There are many articles out there. There's one on The Guardian. It says the roots of the problem, the controversial book of Alex Hale, of Alex, the controversial history of Alex Haley's book. This was put out in 2017. So you've got people telling you that there's something wrong here. The Roots came out in 1977. I was 14 at that time. So we were in the middle of school, and then suddenly this series comes out that tells you that you come from this prisoners of war situation, and you're looking at your parents, and they don't even know what's going on either. They're like, what's, I don't know, what does that mean? They had no answers for it. It's no surprise if somebody made it up. How could they answer it? But anyway, there are a lot of people that you can check on their version of history. Maybe is more it's they're probably more accurate than what this is. This Alex Haley person, they've done maybe some of them are more spiritually connected, and that's the best way, actually, if you want to get real history, to be connected to your ancestors somehow. But then you have others who also have done enough book studies to sift out what is maybe made up or less accurate, and that which is worthy of reading. But I'll put some links at the bottom of the video.